the Democratic establishment, causing the party to start to get concerned about a possible revolt come August at the DNC convention. Joining us right now to weigh in on this is Republican strategist Boris Epshteyn and Democratic strategist Morris Reed. And gentlemen, thank you both for being here today.
Of course. Boris and Morris.
Yeah, Boris and Morris. Morris, why don't we start with you? Because really, it's your party in the headlines right now that is facing many more difficulties, it seems, than the Republicans. And that's a big switch from what we'd been talking about just a few months ago. What's happening with Bernie Sanders? And will he cause a problem at the convention?
He won't cause a problem. The difference between Bernie Sanders and Donald Trump is that Donald Trump was a disruptor. And by nature, he needed to blow up the party in order to reposition it the way he wants it.
The same thing about Bernie Sanders.
I disagree. I think that Bernie Sanders has been good for the process. I've said this continuously. I believe it. He's energizing a base that needs to get out.
There were people throwing chairs this past weekend in Nevada, and there were threats made against the party woman who had made decisions for who was going to be standing on the ballot. Or for who some of the appointed people would be.
I don't think that that's representative of all Democrats, so we need to dwell on that.
But the same could be said with the Trump supporters who were getting out of line at points, too. And Bernie did not smack things down as much as people expected.
I don't believe that they were representative of the Republican Party as well. So the process is the process. What you have is that Bernie Sanders people don't understand. He keeps winning, but he can't ultimately win. They're frustrated. This represents the frustration.
He's complained with the Kentucky that it's because it's a closed primary system. That the system is rigged against him, even though these rules have been in place for forever.
Well, you understand Bernie was an independent before as well, so he's now in the Democratic Party, so he needs to understand the Democratic Party rules and regulation. But the fact is this. Bernie Sanders has been good for the process, good for Hillary Clinton. She needed to be challenged in the primary. If she wasn't challenged, I think she would have more difficulties in the general election. There are still some issues within the party, as I've been on record talking about it, but I don't believe that Bernie Sanders represents the destruction of the Democratic Party the way Donald Trump did at one time for the Republicans.
There is a big difference between Trump and Bernie Sanders. Guess what? Trump won. So Trump came in from the outside, and he won the primary. He went through the process. And he won state by state and won. Now he's speeding to the nomination and doesn't have to do what Bernie Sanders and his supporters are doing. We also in the Republican Party don't have superdelegates, right? We don't have the system where the votes of the people really don't count. There's a shadowy group.
I'm not going to defend the system on that either. Both of these systems are not open vote systems people. Where a vote is a vote.
Listen, of course, right? Both the systems need fixing. There's no question about it.
They're both convoluted systems that people who haven't been regular members of the party.
If the Republicans had the same power of
would they have
Wasserman
diverted?
Schultz, they would have Jeb Bush would be running. Right,
this is not really about Wasserman Schultz. This is about the process.
Hillary Clinton has more votes than Bush.
Was able to pick the nominee.
It's very easy to defend Hillary Clinton here and say that, you know, Bernie Sanders is doing something wrong. But listen, this guy should be a 5% candidate. Bernie Sanders is like a Kucinich, should be a 5% candidate. It speaks to her terrible weakness as a candidate. Let's look at her history, right? You don't get elected to be first lady. She's won two layup elections to be senator. And she got appointed to be Secretary of State, and she was a horrible one at that, but that's neither here nor there. So that could be, you know, open for discussion from some perspective, not from mine. But my point is, as somebody who stands for election, she has a history of being really bad at it. In 08, she was the presumptive nominee going into it, lost to her. You know, somebody who was not well-known, Barack Obama. And now she's letting Bernie Sanders, a socialist, challenge her so deeply.
I don't believe that's the case. The fact is she's won for three elections. She's won two out of one. I think that's pretty good. There is a challenge within the Democratic Party.
Do you remember the challenger in New York State?
Let me finish here. I think that there is a challenge within the Democratic Party and for our candidate. She needs to figure out her vision thing, her message thing. I'm ready is not very aspirational. It's not a narrative.
So what's
that really
it supposed to be, and is it? How do you make it emotional?
Well, I think that, first of all, she should embrace being a woman. I think she's running away from that. I think that should be something she should embrace. It would be something that will cripple Donald Trump when he goes after her on this issue.
She has to a certain extent. Well, I think she needs to play the woman card. She should pay the Republican.
She's been running for 2 years, and you talk about now she should figure out who she is? She's been running for 2 years. Really, she's been running for 10 years.
She needs to figure out what she needs. What I said was that she needs to figure out a narrative that brings people closer together.
And what is the narrative?
Well, look, at this point, they need to figure it out. But if you look at the narratives that have been the best over the years, Morning in America, it's the economy, stupid, and hope.
Make America great again.
Well, listen, the fact is that people see themselves in that. It's not about them. And our two candidates right now spend too much time talking about themselves. I'm experienced. I'm rich. People need to hear what you're going to do.
Well, you can speak for your candidate. As far as our candidate is concerned, I completely disagree with you. Our candidate is speaking about the troubles with America. Now, let me finish. He's talking about the troubles with America, talking about The changes need to be made on immigration, foreign policy, national security, of course the economy, and taxes. He's talking about bringing in, overhauling the system from every perspective.
Hillary
Clinton, let me finish. Now, Hillary, as far as Hillary Clinton is concerned, she's talking about what? Her history as Secretary of State, again, complete failure. Her time as First Lady.
I think you
have to look at Bill Clinton.
CNBC is not about talking points. People want to hear.
You're the one that's giving talking points about how Bernie Sanders is not a real threat to Hillary Clinton.
First of all, let me say he's not a threat to Hillary Clinton because he won't be the nominee. Let's talk about facts. If he's not a threat,
then why are we talking about him, right?
Hold on a second. Morris, let's talk about the national poll that was released yesterday that showed Donald Trump actually had a leg up on Hillary Clinton in a national election. That's the first of these big polls that I've seen that suggests that. What do you think's happening?
I think that Donald Trump is got a free space right now. He's out there telling a narrative. We've still got some challenges within our party to get past this process.
I thought you said Bernie Sanders wasn't a challenge.
Are you going to let me speak?
Bernie Sanders wasn't a challenge.
I said we have challenges within our party, Boris. Listen to what I'm saying.
You just have to be
so
real.
The fact is that we have a candidate that I believe will ultimately win in November. There are challenges. This is a marathon, not a sprint. There will be a process. You'll get better in the process. But at the end of the day, the person that will win this race will be the person that embraces the American people and talks about a vision of the future that's aspirational, not demagogic.
Donald Trump's been able to relate to people, same to a cab driver as to a billionaire.
Dare I say this whole, Make America Great thing has an aspirational ring to it.
It actually has some undertones that are not appreciated by certain people in the Democratic Party.
That's true, too. That plays
to the narrative of what Donald Trump's ultimate problem will be.
Gentlemen, we are out of time. Guys, thank you both for being here.
Okay, when we come back, the latest on the Egyptian flight.